Okay, buddy, what's the best fight you've seen live, and what's the worst fight you've seen live?
Best fight I've seen live, the best fight I've seen live. Damn, that's tough question. Can I think about that for a minute?
Sure, think about that. Coach, the best fight that I saw live was Real Salvador 1. That was crazy. Crazy atmosphere. Crazy.
Like I said, that's a hard one.
Why?
John, can you think about the...
Real Salvador 1. That's the best one live. Like, you, the energy, the crowd, every round, people on their feet.
I don't know the answer to that one. I definitely don't know the answer to the worst one either.
One of the best ones I saw live was the first James Toney Mike McCollum fight.
Why?
It was just artistry, man, and a good fight. I mean,
The two worst fights that I could think of, maybe Chad Dawson Hopkins. That was just so bad. It was bad from the get.
I was there.
The first one?
Chad Dawson, well, they fought Staples, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
The fans were like, what are we seeing? Like, it was over in one round with our show. Oh, it was weird. Okay. We're just talking about amateur decisions.
I'm trying to think of the worst fight. I'm still trying to think of the worst fight I've ever saw live.
That's a tough one.
We've seen some bad fights. We've seen some really crappy fights.
Oh, yeah. I've seen a whole lot of crappy fights, man.
That's why it's hard.
That's why that's a hard question.
Yeah, because you see some fights you don't even know the guys, really. You're just at, like, a show, the undercard or something, and some of them are pretty...
It's four rounds, but it seems like 20.
Every now and then it happens.
So, buddy, here, the guy explained to me what he meant. He meant when he talked about Ali. People say Ali is the GOAT, but Pacquiao won titles in 8 different weight classes.
Okay, now, this is how I see it. I don't care if he won them in 20 different weight classes. I mean, the bottom line is, because you don't... This is how you can answer this question. There's fighters out there that never were champion back in the 50s, 60s that were greater than guys like Pacquiao.
Can you give me an example? Like who?
You got Charlie Burley, that's one.
He was never a champion?
Nope. You got Ralph Tiger Jones.
Why do you say they were better than Manny? Manny's considered right up there with Floyd. I mean, Floyd number one, Manny number two for our era.
Today, of our era, yes. But you're talking great fighters. When you're talking great fighters, I don't care how many times you won, you know, titles and what weight classes, and that don't matter.
More back in the day.
Okay, so you know what I mean? So, like today you have, in one, like say the WBA, you have a regular champion, interim champion, and then the world champion. What kind of shit is that? You feel me? You know what I mean? So like you have guys that were never champion, that didn't even fight for the title. Charlie Burley didn't even fight for the title.
And you only had one title for each weight class, so it was very hard to win it. And the politics and the money, you're not going to break through it, right?
So, this is the big difference.
Yeah, these guys have like 200 fights on them, 100 fights.
And they fought 15 rounds.
Yeah, they have more knockouts than these guys have fights.
So if they were in our era with their skill set, would they dominate?
Who?
Any of the fighters you mentioned?
And then if they were in this era?
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. Without a doubt. I don't think some of these guys in this era would last in that era. Some of these guys in this era wouldn't last in the 70s.
You don't think so?
Hell no. Think of who would beat Roberto Duran at 135?
I mean, I'm gonna throw a name out there, but he's not alive anymore. Edwin Valero, maybe. He was a beast. 26-0, 26 knockouts. But he fought, you know.
Crazy.
He was a beast. Durant was a killer.
That's true. Durant was an animal, as they tell me.
Okay, then now who would be Ray Leonard?
I'm gonna say something. People disagree with me, but I think Floyd would do good. Okay. Depends on the weight, like 147.
He wouldn't have beat Ray Leonard at 47.
Robert Garcia told me the only guy to beat Floyd was Ray Leonard. I asked him who in the history of boxing would beat Floyd.
Ray Leonard. I'm telling you. Ray Leonard was mean, man. And he could fight, man.
And he moved up all the way to light heavyweight, right?
But at 47?
He threw way more punches than Floyd.
And they're gonna set you up. Combination, everything. I sparred Ray.
He fought him, I know.
He fought him?
Exactly.
But he told me he had a bad leg and a bad arm when they fought.
Probably, I mean.
Now he said he got shot and he still made a comeback fast, but he did fight him.
Yeah, when
it won. Ray Leonard can fight, man.
And you know what's crazy? That he's not punchy.
Huh?
He's not punchy after all his wars. Like he's.
Who's that?
Ray.
Nah. Ray can fight, man.
Thomas Hearns can knock him out of the corner for sure.
Wait, slowly?
Thomas
what?
Hearns.
Tommy Hearns.
Tommy Hearns can kill Mayweather. For sure. No doubt about it.
The only way you beat Tommy Hearns if you're a puncher. If you're not a puncher, you ain't beat Tommy Hearns.
Yeah.
If he beat Ray had become a puncher, because he couldn't outbox no Tommy.
Nah.
That jab right hand is a monster.
Is that Aaron Gordon? Because he's not, he just came with the welterweight now because he can pick and choose who he's fighting.
Who would have beat Aaron Pryor?
He wouldn't do that.
Yeah. Who would have beat Aaron Pryor?
Didn't even want to fight him.
At 140, who would have beat Aaron Pryor in this era?
By the way, buddy, have you met him lately, Aaron Pryor?
I haven't seen him in a while.
The Pride of Cincinnati?
I haven't seen him in a while, but, I mean.
What's he doing these days, do you know?
I have no clue. I remember in 85, when I was coming up, my manager called me like, buddy, we might have a chance to fight Aaron Pryor. I said, when? He said, the next 6 months. I'm like, you gotta be crazy, man.
You wanted more time?
Yeah. Man, that man was a straight up beast, killer, whatever, man. Nobody wanted to fight him. The only guy who stepped up to the plate was Arguello. No, Ray Leonard didn't want to fight him. Hearns, nobody wanted to fight him, man. Nobody wanted to fight Aaron Pryor.
Aaron Pryor's the only guy I seen get knocked out, and then the referee had to pull him off the other guy.
Look, none of these guys, man. At 140, man.
Buddy, didn't Pryor beat Leonard and Hearns in the amateurs?
He beat Hearns.
Hearns was only 17 years old, though. And Aaron Pryor was a little older, so.
Who would beat Marvin Hagler?
Him and Golovkin would be a good fight. I'd like to see that one. All
right.
James, Tony, and Golovkin. I'd love to see that one.
Oh, yeah.
A young James, Tony?
Yeah, young James told me. Well, not now, but yeah, when James was 160.
James.
Why?
Shit.
What? Why? Just go back and look at the tapes of him, man.
No, but is it fair to say Golovkin's the most feared right now?
I mean, yeah, he's the most feared, but I think that, you know, him fighting a young James Tony, man, now. James would took him to school, man.
James ain't gonna run around the ring either. He's gonna stand there.
No, James had reflexes you can't teach.
He's gonna stand there and make a miss. I'd like to see like Roy Jones even in his prime middleweight versus Golovkin. That would be interesting.
That'd be interesting, yeah. But I mean, there's so many, man. Listen, let me tell you, man. I'm a realist about a lot of things, you know. Like, I was standing next to Tommy Hearns at the Hall of Fame one year. I'm looking at how long his arms were.
Shit.
I'm like, this guy was 147.
That's what I say. He's like 6'2", right?
Ain't no way in the hell I'd have fought that. He could tie his shoes without bending over, man. Ray Leonard said that Tommy Hearns' jab was like getting hit with a right hand. You know what I mean? Can you imagine Broner fighting the Tommy Hearns? He get locked up for murder, Tommy Hearns, man. Broner should stay at 135. 135, he'd be all right. Those other guys too big, man. Wait. Too big, man.
Yeah, Broner's very small person. Mm-hmm. Very small.
Well, four-time champion in four different weight classes.
Yeah, but that's the problem,
yeah, that
man.
Doesn't mean much these days.
Doesn't mean nothing today, man.
Call yourself
a right.
So when they start saying stuff like that.
Like this guy that's 48-0 with two knockouts. I never heard of him. You know what I mean? And he's the IBF champion.
What weight is it?
I don't know. But he's going for it. He's going right now. He's fighting in Russia, I believe. I mean, he's going for the title record of 49-0.
Knockout.
I mean, so it's crazy, man.
Unless he puts on a clinic like Willie Pep or something, then I'd watch it. But I don't think anybody can move like that.
Okay, Willie Pep, you know, they say he's one of the greatest. How many times did he beat Sandy Sadler?
1 out of 5, I think. One
there you go. So as Sandy Sadler once says, if he's great, what does that make me? But Sandy Sadler don't get the props.
Why not?
Because he wasn't as artistic as Pep.
He had trouble with other guys, too.
Yeah.
Look. Not everybody could do what Mayweather does. You have other fighters who fight that style, but Mayweather is the pound for pound king. He makes $300 million in 36 minutes.
Right, I mean, look, listen, you're right. I agree with you 150%. Nobody can do what he does. But he's never had a guy beat him 5 out of 6 times either.
That's true. He hasn't fought anybody 6 times. That's true.
Maybe they fought 5, I don't know.
How many is that, Isaac?